I would argue that there are two pillars of American conservatism. There's social conservatism, the sort of family values, traditionalism, Christianity, Christian coalition, whatever labels you want to put on it. And then the other pillar is the libertarian pillar, or the classical liberal pillar. Free markets, free minds, free trade, limited government, the sovereignty of the individual. And these two pillars define American conservatism. And the further you move to either one of them, the more you're called a right-winger. Well, both of these pillars were exactly what the fascists stood against. The fascists hated traditional Christianity, they hated traditional values, and they hated libertarianism. They hated freedom, they hated individualism, they hated free markets. When the liberals call conservatives fascists, it's not because they actually know what they're talking about. They call conservatives fascists because they want conservatives to shut up. It's the same reason that they immediately call conservatives racists. It's because they have nowhere else to go. They want the conversation to end. They don't want to entertain conservative ideas. What they want to do is make conservative ideas radioactive by demonizing them as things they are not.